Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a LEGO Star Wars set that came out in 2008. This is called the Republic Fighter Tank. Came with 592 pieces. It includes two clone trooper minifigures, which we'll look at up close later on. This is a Clone Wars era hover tank, so it's not touching the ground, supposedly. This one's actually done with wheels on the bottom, and they're just really small, thin wheels that roll very easily, actually, and they make it so that you can still turn the thing around, because they're hard and they're thin, so you can turn the thing around pretty easily. So it has kind of a realistic kind of hovering motion to it. I really appreciate that. Most folks who recognize this vehicle would recognize it from the Battlefront games. I don't think it ever showed up in any of the movies. If it did, it was very, very brief. This has two main guns, these ones on the sides, and those can be rotated up and down, and those are supposed to be laser cannons, so direct sight fire. And they also have little hidden missiles down in the side pods. These actually rotate around, they flip completely, and that reveals three, those are supposed to be concussion missiles, but they're flick fire missiles here on each side, and those can be fired out by hand, and they do fold away quite nicely. I like these entire side pods. I like the way that they're detailed. They do have one large sticker on each side and then one small one here at the end, but I think that's really important for just capturing the look of the thing properly. And each of these sections here is a little personal weapons storage for one of your minifigures. So we have two of the medium-sized blasters here, and there are two pistols on the other side. Only tricky thing here is that you do need to put the weapons in just the right spot so that they'll fit in the little C kind of groove. Otherwise, this little door won't close up all the way. The side pods do have a realistic angle down to the sides to them, and this whole tank has a very aggressive look from the front. Interestingly enough, these spots right here that look like they're black actually are transparent black, so if you let a little bit of light in there, you could actually see inside the main cabin. Now, there is a hinge on the front here, and that allows you to open up this section that just basically exposes the power core. It's kind of your engine detail, if you will. Up on top is a kind of point defense cannon turret, which can be turned side to side, just as the twin barrels there. It can also be turned up and down, and this is a main hatch. Now, that actually has an interesting thing set up with it that actually interacts with the back, because you've got another big door back here. And this is, I guess this would be more of the main hatch for entry and exit, or it could be seen as an escape hatch. The top one's more just for the gunner. But the way this is set up, there's actually a little trigger mechanism inside with a rubber band. The top part is spring-loaded, so when you pull this out, watch what happens. The guy comes up and the top hatch opens up. That's a really nice, slick, simple little setup, and it just works really well. So whenever you need that guy to come up, so I'm just gonna go ahead and reset it. It kind of works like a mousetrap. Whenever you want him to pop out, you just pull that and out he comes. And it's a very straightforward little thing. It's just this little hinge piece that holds on to a little bit of a Technic assembly that sticks out right there, and that's just it. Here's how it looks from the top. You can also remove this entire top to really see the full interior of the cabin, but it just takes off the roof section. That also lets you see that mechanism a little bit better. And there you can see how you've got the transparent windows there, so you can kind of see inside a little bit. The guy's eyes don't really line up, but he's going to be mostly using a console in front of him. And you can see that you just have a little bit of room. You can see inside of there he has two printed slope pieces that are 2x2, have a couple consoles, and that's what he's going to be using. Unfortunately, that figure down there does have to remove his outer armor add-on pieces in order to be able to sit in that seat. So you have to kind of reconfigure him a little bit. But there you see the rubber band that's used for the little lifting mechanism. Very, very straightforward. Here are the two minifigs fully accessorized, and these do have the same prints for their torsos, their heads, and their headgear, or the helmets. Just have different amounts of accessories attached. So you see this guy comes with all that he needs to get fully decked out with the visor and the little armor plate up on top, and he's also got the parts that cover around the sides and backs of the legs. I put the two pistols on him. I also attached this included little booster antenna to the other guy there. So there you see the prints that are on the backs of them. Again, this is going to be exactly the same, the one on the right underneath as the one on the left. And when it comes to faces for these are from the Clone Wars series, the cartoon based ones. So they both have the kind of freaky looking, bug-eyed, angry or kind of pensive clones, I would say. Well, this was a good one, I think. I liked the look of this thing, you know, in-universe, the real thing, if you would, has just a nice aggressiveness to it and kind of pulls from a bunch of different things from the history of sci-fi. And I think that LEGO did a really good job of making a toy out of it, making a LEGO product out of it. It was an enjoyable build through and through. Had a lot of medium-sized pieces, you know, just the right size of piece that you want to have for building up something of this size. Not too many pieces were very large. The number of stickers, I think, is perfectly fine for this set. Didn't bother me at all. The little mechanisms, I think, work well. The way that the wheels are set up, that works well. The figures, you know, we can always use more figures, but they gave you the right number for this vehicle. And overall, it just seems like something that would be really fun to play with for kids. It looks good on display. It went together well. I think that everything that you want out of a LEGO set for kids through adults, I think, is pretty well captured here. So that's it for my look at this set. Hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you have any comments about this set that you'd like to share with myself and the other viewers as well. Thank you for taking the time to watch the video, and I'll be talking to you again very, very soon.